Hello everyone. This lecture is meant to lay the biological foundations for some concepts that will become very useful in the course. We will talk within chapter 2 about chromosomes, genes, alleles, as well as various types of inherited and non-inherited genetic disorders. What are chromosomes? Chromosomes are nothing more than strands of DNA. Every single cell in your body, from your toes to the cells that make up your hair, are composed of 23 pairs of chromosomes, or a total of 46. So, chromosomes are inherited from dad in sperm, so 23, and from mom in eggs, 46, making up a complete set of 46 chromosomes that you inherit in this genetic shuffle. There's two main kinds of chromosomes, meaning that they could either code for sex characteristics, be associated with them, like the sex chromosomes X and Y, or the vast majority, the first 23 pairs, which we call autosomes or autosomal chromosomes, that code for other things in your body that are not necessarily sex-linked. Everything about you, your psychological makeup in terms of personality or propensity to psychological disorders or health, your metabolism, all of these, again, are due to your nature and nurture, to the genes that you inherited from mom and dad, as well as the lifestyle and environment that you grew up in. Human beings have about 20,000 genes, and these are nothing more than DNA. So DNA makes up genes, which make up chromosomes. And as such, genes are basic units of heredity. They're little blueprints for the structures in your body and your psychological makeup that you get from mom and dad. They're like a computer code for every cell in your body that tells it what to do in terms of protein and enzyme synthesis. What are alleles? Well, genes generally come in at least two flavors, one allele and another allele. So alleles are gene variations, genes having at least two states. You get one allele generally from each parent. They can be dominant, they can be recessive or intermediate. So for example, your eye or hair color that you get from mom and dad will come, again, coded in a chromosome, a strand of genes, and in a particular location, you'll find the gene that codes for hair or eye color. This gene, again, can have different variants, say blonde or blue or dark brown or light blue eyes, right? These are the various forms or alleles. Generally, an allele will be dominant over another. Brown is dominant over blue in terms of eye color or hair. So in order to get blue eyes, you will have to have two recessive or non-dominant alleles in order for it to express itself. We're going to look at an example shortly. Also, in terms of autosomal or sex-linked expressions, we know that, for example, color vision deficiency or color blindness is associated with the X or Y chromosome. Men are about 10 times more likely than women to be colorblind, most commonly being unable to tell, say, red from green color. But many or most disorders are not sex-linked. They're associated with the other chromosomes, the other 22 pairs. And for example, Down syndrome is one such disorder that is autosomal. It's actually located on the 21st chromosome where there is an extra copy or duplication. So as an example of inheritance, let's look at hair color. Relevant to say here that your genotype is generally a word used to refer to basically your set of genes that you got from mom and dad. Whereas your phenotype is used to refer to the physical, behavioral, and psychological traits that you actually express, not just that are in your genes. So once again, say we're looking at hair color. You have a pair of chromosomes here that are strands of genes, one from dad, one from mom. At particular locations in those chromosomes on both strands, you get the spot, the gene that that codes for hair color. So here from dad, from mom, and then you have two different alleles, which can be, say, for example, brown or blonde hair. So in this case, the dad has light brown hair, and the mom has dark brown hair, phenotypically, the observed physical trait. But what about their genes? What would they look like if you were to give them a genetic test? Well, we would see that they have an allele that is dark brown, the big D, as well as an allele that is little b, coding for blonde. So genetically, they're carriers of this blonde hair gene, even though they don't express it phenotypically. So what will their kids look like? If you do the probability of mixing and matching these genotypes, you will end up with a probability that about 3/4 of their kids will have brown hair, because brown is dominant over blonde. So two combinations of brown will end up brown phenotypically. One brown and one blonde will become brown because brown trumps blonde. It is dominant over the recessive blonde. And the only way that 1/4 of the child, so 1 in 4 children, is likely to become, to be blonde, is because they will be carriers of the two alleles that are recessive, and therefore combined, they can express themselves phenotypically. How does this apply to genetic disorders? There are two main categories of disorders that are genetic. Some are inherited, that you get from mom and dad. So, for example, sickle cell disease, where your oxygen-carrying red blood cells are misshapen in the form of a sickle, and therefore you end up with symptoms like fatigue, prolonged pain, infections, etc. This is a type of recessive inherited disorder. You need two of those alleles to express it. PKU, or phenylketonuria, is another inherited genetic disorder that is recessive, in which you have a deficiency in a liver enzyme that converts a phenylalanine amino acid, and therefore can result in mental retardation and seizures, etc. Every child born in the U.S. is tested for PKU. These are recessive inherited disorders, but you also have dominant ones more rarely, meaning that you only need one allele in order to express this disorder. Huntington's disease is a devastating progressive neurodegenerative disorder that results in motor problems, cognitive and psychiatric problems, and it can show up pretty early in life. And you have a video that you should watch in your web link section, as well as in the discussion forum assignment, where you will see a Huntington's disease posting for you to offer your thoughts. But a different category of genetic disorders are non-inherited chromosomal abnormalities. Saying that something is genetic and inherited is not the same thing. So something can be genetic but happen along the way of development and not necessarily be gotten from mom or dad. So an extra missing or damaged chromosome can show up sometime in utero, for example. And this is the case of Down syndrome, where you get a duplication or an extra copy of chromosome 21, hence the name trisomy 21. But also Turner syndrome is another example of a non-inherited chromosomal abnormality where mainly women have a damaged or missing X chromosome, resulting in physical characteristics like short height, infertility, etc. For this mini lecture, you should be able to explain basic heredity concepts as well as apply them to inherited and non-inherited disorders as we just discussed.